the number of electric vehicles or EVs joining the roadway continues to surge, so does the need for EV chargers. The installation of charging stations may not be as simple as some may think, since it involves not just the charger itself, but the entire electric vehicle charging infrastructure, or EVCI. To explain more about the basics of EV charging and EVCI, you can check out our video that covers topics such as the different charging levels, how much time it takes to charge an EV, different connectors, and more. But for now, we are going to focus on a level 2 AC charging solution. Level 2 chargers are commonly mounted on pedestals in a parking lot or parking garage for commercial use and supplied with 208 volts AC or 240 volts AC for residential applications. Here at Eaton's Power Systems Experience Center, or PSEC, you can see a pedestal style installation where we have two 19.2 kilowatt chargers and one 11.5 kilowatt charger installed. It wasn't a major task to power them with short conduit and cable runs because they were right next to the building. Our next step was to install an EV charger for all 12 parking spots under our solar canopy we have installed here at the PSEC. One option was to install 6 dual-sided pedestals with a charger installed on each side. This was not a good option for us because we would have to dig up the parking lot to run all new underground conduits and conductors from the building to the 6 pedestals. But lucky for us, we had an existing 200 amp, 208 volt feed going to a piece of equipment under the solar canopy that was no longer in use. So we wanted to use that for our new EV chargers. This means there was already conduit in place that contained 3-aught copper conductors, but unfortunately, that was the maximum capacity we could get out of that conduit size. This limited the number and type of level 2 chargers we could add under the canopy. So we had a dilemma. We could either go with just a couple chargers under the canopy or redesign the system somehow to allow for more. After considering what we knew about our chargers, available sizes, and ampacity of the existing wire, we determined that we had several options all made possible by using Eaton's EV Smart Breaker chargers. This level 2 AC charger provides 7.7 kilowatts at 240 volts or 6.7 kilowatts at 208 volts. It has the option for a direct connect kit that installs like a normal breaker in a BR load center or a BAB breaker in a Powerline 3X panelboard. There's also an option for an EV wall charger that utilizes this EV smart breaker. The J1772 connector and 25-foot pre-made cord with patented LED design to indicate state can be directly connected to the smart breaker charger. The other installation method for this charger is the direct connect plus junction box kit that allows you to run the proper conduit and cable from the charger up to 250 feet to the junction box. Then, the J1772 connector and the pre-made cord simply connect to the terminal blocks within the junction box. The EV Smart Breaker charger also includes revenue accurate metering, as well as Wi-Fi connectivity that allows for remote monitoring control through a mobile app. It also has an open API platform that allows it to be integrated with a preferred software platform. This would allow us to control the schedule of vehicle charging for Eaton employees and PSEC visitors. We decided to investigate 3 options that all include the EV Smart Breaker charger. 1, the EV charging panelboard. 2, the EV charging switchboard. And 3, the EV charging IFS switchboard. Eaton's EV charging panelboard can integrate up to 10 EV Smart Breaker chargers, providing a single, space-saving, and factory-assembled solution. While this would be a great option, we really wanted to install 12 chargers. Another option was to install one of Eaton's EV charging switchboards that permits up to 18 of the EV Smart Breaker chargers integrated into an EV panel board installed in a single switchboard structure, 26 inches wide by 18 inches deep and 90 inches tall. This option enables us to install the 12 chargers, but we would not be able to simultaneously run all of them at maximum capacity with the 200 amp, 208 volt feed. But what if we were able to convert the 208 volt feed to 480 volts using the same wire that is already installed and place a transformer outside under the canopy and then feed the switchboard? Now we are getting to a solution that would work. But what if, even better, we could install the transformer inside the switchboard and have one complete factory wired solution? Oh wait, we can. And that leads us to our final option. Our final option was exactly what we were looking for. Eaton's Integrated Facility Systems, or IFS switchboard, that gives the option to add adjacent integrated electrical distribution components, such as an upstream transformer and control equipment, into a single space-saving factory-assembled and connected system. With this setup, we would have even more room for growth or expansion and the option to feed additional loads at the 480 volt level. The flexibility of this design future-proofs our installation. We were able to check all the boxes with our NEMA 3R IFS EV charging switchboard that includes a 150 kVA 480 to 208 volt transformer and an integrated EV panel board. The panel board includes 12 EV smart breaker chargers and additional spaces to connect solar inverters from the canopy, lighting, surge protection, and some auxiliary 120 volt loads. This was made possible by a simple reconfiguration inside the building to change the original underground 208 volt feeder to 480 volts. The reconfigured underground feeder fed the transformer, which stepped the voltage down to 208 volts or 120 volts. The transformer then fed the panel board with the EV chargers and other loads. Finally, with the limitation of 25 feet on the J1772 cord, we used the Direct Connect Plus Junction Box kit to supply power to each parking spot. The next thing we considered that is one of the most important for EV charging installations was cable management. With our installation location being under a solar canopy, we had the ability to run all the conduit and wire overhead and use drops with retractors to keep charging cords organized and off the ground where they are likely to get damaged or destroyed. A key benefit offered by the integrated solution is the improved security for the hardware. EV chargers are installed inside a secured and locked enclosure. Overall, a solution like the one we installed helps building owners and property managers save time, effort, and cost while providing safe and reliable EV charging services. Since this video was focused on a specific installation here at the PSEC using the Level 2 EV smart breaker chargers, we didn't cover the many other charging options Eaton has to offer. As we referenced before, some of the Level 2 options include 19.2, 11.5, and 9.6 kilowatt wall-mounted or pedestal-mounted chargers. Another unique solution using the 19.2 kilowatt charger is EV charging busway that is engineered to enable fast, flexible, and scalable EV charging for fleet, services with multiple passenger vehicles or medium-duty trucks, and last-mile delivery. Check out this other video we did that covers a few examples of large-scale Level 2 AC charging installations and considerations that should be made. Another form of EV charging that is getting a lot of attention is DC fast charging, which is capable of charging at 150 kilowatts, for example. This large amount of power is no longer supplied by 240 or 208 volts, but rather supplied by 480 volts AC three-phase. We go into much more detail in our other video specifically about DC fast charging. Interestingly, now that we have a 480 volt feed under the canopy in our new switchboard, that gives us options to add DC fast charging later if we decide. Obviously, we would have to reconsider the size of the DC charger and coordinate with the other AC chargers already installed. Hopefully this video, as well as the other videos we pointed out, will provide you with a better understanding of your options for EV charging as we continue to support the energy transition. To learn more about EV charging and many different applications and installations for your power system, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to one of Eaton's Power Systems Experience Centers today.